Hey friend, welcome to your 5-minute Bible teaching from Back to the Bible. I'm your host, Pastor Nat. You know, as a coach, I exist to help you not just win the day, but do so with excellence. And that's why you're here. So let's win the day together by understanding how we can never outgive God. I'm just curious, what would you say to me if you were at my home for dinner? You desired a nice marbled ribeye with maybe a twice-baked potato and some bacon-wrapped asparagus. I said, "Don't worry. Don't worry about it. I got you covered." So I disappear to the kitchen. You hear me banging around in there. And I come through the doors and I put down your plate. On it was a cracker, a piece of celery, and maybe a ding-dong. What would you feel? What would you say? I'll be honest, I'm a foodie, so I would probably throw that plate across the room and I would walk out the door. But if Paul would have been there, his reaction would have been remarkably different. Let's turn back to Philippians 4:18 to understand why. I have received full payment and more. I am well supplied, having received from Epaphroditus the gifts you sent, a fragrant offering, a sacrifice acceptable and pleasing to God. And my God will supply every need of yours according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Paul has been talking now for quite some time about a mind focused on truth. Well, the truth is God is good and the provider of all of our needs. When Paul focused on his goodness and the adequate provision for his needs, he was content. That's why Paul says here, "I am well supplied by your gifts." Well supplied has the idea of overflowing. It's like someone refilling your iced tea and just keeps pouring and pouring and pouring as it spills all over the table. When the Philippian church gave freely, regardless of the amount, it was an acceptable offering that brought God pleasure. You see, we don't know if Paul received $1, $100, or $1,000. To Paul, it was what he needed. Sure, he may have wanted the double cheeseburger combo meal, but ended up with a kiddie meal. He frankly didn't care. He was thankful. He was content. It was about their motives and his heart. And then Paul gives the secret to continuous giving. God will supply all of your needs. In other words, you cannot outgive God. Now, I'm going to say that again. You cannot outgive God. Now, it's true. Some of us may have outkicked our coverage when we got married, but friend, we can never outgive God. God holds all the resources. So when we give 5, 10, 20% of our resources, God knows what we need. He will refill the bucket accordingly. Now, I didn't say that if you give $10, God gives you 10 back. But what he will do is he will provide what you need. I practice it, I experience it, and I want you to as well. So here's my challenge for you today. Trim and give. Many people will say, "I just can't give any money away to my church. I can't give any money to your ministry. I just don't have the margin." I'm going to tell you, the problem isn't a lack of resources, usually. It's a lack of stewardship and self-discipline. So I encourage you, take some time and look at your spending and find just one thing that you can reduce or eliminate so you can give joyfully to God's kingdom. I have seen in my own life that when I live within my means and I give generously, God provides abundantly. You can never outgive God, but try it and then see the blessings grow.